What's up, everyone? This is me just expressing my feelings about today's day and age, man. I mean, like, everybody's priorities are so messed up, you know, like, it's fucked up that the way girls treat themselves, you know, and then how guys treat them, you know. It's because, like, if you look at it, they're not really chicks that put themselves. You can't expect to be treated as a princess and you walk around with your belly button showing, you know, half damn near half naked, you get me? You can't expect a guy to respect you or hold you to a higher standard, you know? But at the same time, dudes have lost respect for the women, you get me? Like, there's no more, yes ma'am, let's hold the door for a lady, where are the gentlemen at, you get me? I mean, I don't know if it's the TV or whatever it is, or it's just people not giving a fuck anymore, you know, of what it used to be a man, and what it used to be a woman, you get me? And I mean, maybe women just don't respect themselves enough to demand that respect, or maybe this day and age just doesn't give a fuck about that, I don't know. I see it, it makes me sad, you get me? Because, I mean, when you look at a woman, she's, you know, it's an amazing thing, you get me? Like, they're here for a reason. Every guy thinks they're beautiful. You get me? But, I mean, you being 12 years old, walking around the mall with your belly button showing, you know, some tight-ass pants that you probably took 30 minutes to squeeze into. It's not sexy. It's not even attractive. You get me? And how can you expect a man to think of you anything more than a piece of meat when that's what you present yourself as? You get me? When you dress like that, you're presenting yourself as a piece of meat. You get me? A guy looks at that like, okay, she just looked fuck. Alright, boom. If you want a guy to respect you, you have to respect yourself. Wear less revealing clothes. Don't be as tight. Yeah, some guys ain't gonna look at you. But then you get the understanding, because everybody's intention on what they want in a relationship is not the same. Some dudes just want a bang, you get me? Some dudes just like, yo, I'm gonna hit it and quit it. Some dudes actually want that commitment, you know? Some dudes trying to be your Romeo, but you're too busy looking at the Tupac Shakur's, you know? They ain't going nowhere in life. They gonna end up where he ended up, you get me? The whole point is, don't expect a man to do more for you than what you do for yourself. If you're dressing, if you're revealing all that, you're letting it all hang out, then the guy's gonna do. He sees that and he feels like, all right, she doesn't respect herself. Why I gotta go to extra level? You get me? And I mean, it's not cool, but that's reality, you know. And I didn't make this video to get likes and, you know, be Facebook famous. I made this video because it's the truth. It's the honest truth. I mean, everybody sees it. You go to the mall, you see it. You turn on the TV, you see it. Facebook, you see it. It's fucked up the way this generation's going, you know? I mean, it sucks. I mean, I personally think that the relationships, I know everybody has a grandma or grandpa, and you see the love they had, and they've probably been together for like 40 or 50 years, but they did that off of commitment, you know? She had standards, and she held them standards, and he had to meet those standards. You get me? She respected herself. Today, like, I mean, it's cool if you want to look sexy, but just know that looking sexy is going to get all the attention. But with all that attention, you're not going to get 100% of the dudes that really want to be in a relationship. You get all the dudes that want to fuck you, but you won't get all the dudes. It's going to be harder to tell the difference. Dress classy, less revealing, wear less tighter clothes. Show like you respect yourself just a little bit. You know, talk with decency, because I don't know when do people think it's sexy for a chick to be like, yeah, fuck that bitch, that's not hot.
Listen,
like,
to the hottest fuck soundtrack that bitch this year.
That's not cute.
Music,
like,
from
50
Shades,
it's not cute. You know, cute is like
Gallivant.
Witty, funny, tell a joke. But when you just use profanity and you're like, fuck that bitch, yeah, bitch can't do shit. Come on, that's not cute. You can't expect a dude to want to be with you or respect you as an individual, you don't show that for yourself. You can't expect anything less. You get me?
Listen to the music of this year's Grammy Awards from nominated artists like Sam Smith.
I mean, I wish it was better. I wish it was different, but it's not. That's the age we live in. So, ladies, maybe you should try this. I don't know. I'm not your daddy. I can't tell you how to dress. You get me? But I'm just saying that if a guy only wants to talk to you, if you have to show skin, if you have to show skin to get a guy to talk to you, then that guy's not worth your time. You know? If a guy's always asking, send me a pic. You get me? Like, if he's saying, send me a pic of you smiling, cool. But if he's like, flash yourself, like, come on. Because at the end of the day, you never know if that relationship is going to last. 99% sure it's not. If he's just met you and he's already asking for pics, it's not going to last. So, you send it to him, then he's pissed off, or he just thinks it's cool, or his homeboys like hype him up to do some stupid shit. Now your picture's all over the internet. You get me? Now you're another Amanda Todd or whatever her name was. You get me? And it's sad to what happened to her. Rest in peace. You get me? But it's fucked up, and we need to hand each other. We need to hold ourselves accountable for the mistakes we make. And we can't blame other people for the people we attract into our life, because it's our habits, the way we handle ourselves, how we do. You get me? You don't see a gangster, you know, like hanging out with Bill Gates. You don't see Bill Gates hanging out with rappers. You get me? If he hangs out with anybody, he's got money, he doesn't got any shit, he still gets paid. But the things you do, the way you dress, the way you act, it attracts the crowd that you're going to be with, unfortunately. Ladies, respect yourself more. Clean up your mouths. Stop showing so much skin. And you'll find a guy who really cares. Because if he looks at you and you're not showing any skin, and he still thinks you're beautiful, and you don't got to like show off how big your ass is or how big your boobs is, because in reality, that shit's fool's gold. You get me? Outer appearances means nothing. It might be sexy. It might turn you on the way a guy looks or how a chick looks. But when it comes down to an actual relationship, it takes more than looks. Personality. What good is having a hot dude, a guy you consider hot, and then he calls you a bitch, or you look at another dude and he grabs you rough, or he roughs you up? What's the point of being with someone who hits you and doesn't even respect you as an individual, doesn't trust you? Because in a relationship, it takes trust. It sucks, you know? So don't be one of them girls that fall victim to these fake wannabe Romeos. You need to find your real Romeo, and that starts by cleaning up yourself, because it always, like Michael Jackson said it best. I mean, you can say, everybody has their own opinion about the dude. He was a great artist. Whatever he did in his personal life, I don't really know. I wasn't there, so I can't say, I can't judge him. But you gotta look at the man in the mirror, and in this case, the woman in the mirror, because what you give out to the world, it gives back to you. And it saddens me, dude. Like, it sucks. Like, I don't like seeing no woman cry, dude. I don't like seeing that shit. I don't like seeing women get disrespected. I mean, it's fucked up. And it's fucked up that some chicks think it's okay or it's normal. It's not okay. It's not normal. It's not okay for a dude to touch you. It's not okay for him to put his hands on you. It's not. You're better than that. You get me? You were created for a greater meaning than just to be some housewife or get your ass whooped because you don't do what he says. And dudes, stop acting like she's your slave, because in reality, she's not, dude. Get me? She's not your slave. She's a human being just like you. She has rights. She's free to do whatever she wants. If she's your girl, you respect her. If she says something, you just go with that. You like, if she says, hey babe, like, I'm gonna go hang out with the girls, don't be like, alright babe, and then like try to sneak up and check up on her. It's not trust. And at the end of the day, you go in there, you're gonna only find out two things. One, she cheating on you, which I mean is a good thing to find out. Two, she's gonna catch you spying on her, she's gonna get mad, and then you're gonna destroy the trust. And in the end, that destroys the relationship. Dudes, we gotta trust our women, we gotta respect our women, and we gotta step up. You know, like if you're committed to a girl, stay with that girl, love that girl, give that girl your all, you get me? Don't flip-flop every 5 seconds, you know? Don't say you love someone and then text another chick. Because at the end of the day, the face is gonna fade, the tits gonna sag, the ass is gonna sag, the pussy gonna stretch. Why the fuck? Why the fuck waste your time running for those things? You get me? When you can find that girl who got your back 100% of the time, who doesn't care picking up the checkbook when you ain't got enough money in your pocket, you get me? Who doesn't mind buying you gifts, who doesn't ask for material things, because so much shit is so much energy. Yo, if he doesn't love me, if he don't buy me honor and $20 bear, if he don't buy me chocolate, he don't love me. What happened to writing your own little card was enough? What happened to just little simple stuff every once in a while was enough? Cause if a dude with money can buy you all this shit, but if he's beating your ass when you get home, or he's sleeping with another woman, what good is he to you? What good is having all this nice stuff and not being happy? Money can't make you happy, ladies. In reality, yeah, it's nice, it makes shit easier. But that's not love. So ladies, we need to work on being faithful to our man, sticking by our man's side, you know? Not always bringing him down. And dudes, you have to step up too. You have to be more faithful, man. You gotta be willing and committed in a relationship. Stop fucking around with other chicks. Stop messaging 100 other women. I mean, if y'all gonna be together and y'all both like social media, make a Facebook together. Delete the other Facebook. Y'all together. Get me? She can log in, you can log in. Boom. Y'all add friends who you want. You socialize. And stop believing what other fuckers say about you, you know? Because in reality, nobody, other people who aren't happy or don't have that relationship they want, and they see you happy and you're in a good relationship, they're gonna hate on you. They're gonna talk mad shit, and they're gonna try to jock your relationship, and they're gonna try to fucking piss you off. They're gonna say, hey, you see them over there? And then they're gonna run, and they're gonna try to fuck your shit up. But don't let that happen. Her word comes first to you. His word comes first to her. You get me? Y'all together. It's you and him against the world. That's how it's supposed to be. I mean, that's just real, and I mean, I don't want to make this video too long, because then it might not upload, and then I'm like, just waste of time talking, but that's straight from the heart, and I mean, yeah, so, let's step it up, let's bring love back, you know, it's 2015, love's been gone a while, you know, true love has not been here for a while, like, it's on the brink of extinction. So, let's change that person in the mirror, and let's bring love back, ladies.